So from this point onwards, we will try to make sure that the session is being recorded. Right. I hope everybody is able to see the PowerPoint presentation slide, internet technologies introduction part. So in this video meeting, let us have something to be understood related to the course. Something on what is this course is all about, why do we require this course, and how do we go about this course during this semester. So before we go into the syllabus of this course, let me emphasize on three important things: what this course is all about, and of course, why we require this course. In other terms, why do you need to study this course? And how do you go about in learning this particular course in terms of the prescribed syllabus? Before we try to understand or try to go to the internal details of the syllabus, let me give you a simple scenario here where we try to do these activities normally every day. Assume that you have a computer or a laptop with you, and also you have something to be retrieved from the internet. So it need not be a laptop, but here I'm just giving you some kind of indication what we need to do about here. So this can be a laptop, or this particular can be a mobile phone or a smartphone or any electronic gadget. So what we do here normally on this particular computer. So here on this computer or at this particular site, what we do here is you try to, just hold on, one student is now joining. Yes. So what you do from this particular laptop, usually you try something like this. Right. So from your laptop or from your mobile, what you are trying to understand here is, through your browser, you are entering some text at the URL of the browser. The text is related to something which you like to know, or something which you like to retrieve, or something which you like to get some information. The information which is present at some other place. The some other place is this particular on the right side. Basically, it can be a server, it can be a workstation, it can be some other high computing device which is not located near to your place or near to your requesting site or requesting location. So what you try to do here is you try to enter this URL on the browser, and once you enter this URL on the browser, what is exactly happening is, so your request is, your request is going from your device to some other location, and this particular location or this particular device is a very, basically you call it as a remote device, or you can call it as a something called as a server. So basically you are trying to request some information from your device, from your device you are trying to request some information where the information is present at the remote site. And what the server is going to do, so whatever the information that you have requested, obviously that server is going to send some responses for us. So this information that you are getting from the server is called as basically a response. So the responses will be depending on what the information you are trying to look for. So on the computer or the electronic device which you are requesting, this particular device or this particular electronic gadget or this particular equipment or a computing device, you usually give some term called as this particular side or device which you call it as here is acting like a client. So a client is a device or a user who is trying to request some information which is available or present at a different location, and you get some responses from the server to your side. That side is called as basically a client. So this is how usually happens in our day-to-day life. This can be from your mobile device. Sometimes you may have to download some files from this server. Sometimes you may have to see some emails or some email exchange of information is happening here. Sometimes you may have to download some movies, audios, which are present on a remote server. So basically, there is something which is happening between these two devices or these two locations. That activity is basically nothing but we term it as exchange of information between these two devices. So the exchange of information, that information which you like to have it at your place or on your device, the device can be a mobile, laptop, or a desktop, or any electronic gadget which supports in getting that requested information which is available at some other location. So this course, Internet Technologies, is basically you need to understand how the information is being getting exchanged between these two entities, between these two devices, or between a set of devices. So in order to have proper communication between these two devices or exchange of information to be very effective, what are the things that you need to understand? It is basically related to our communication principles or communication practices that you need to follow. So the rules have to be followed between these two entities in order to have a proper exchange of data. So there may be certain rules which you call it as certain protocols. So what are all the protocols that needs to be understood in order to have some knowledge or in order to send some information or in order to receive some information from various other electronic devices which are connected between these two devices? So one more important information that we like to have here is between these two devices is what actually you have here is these two devices are connected by a network. In simple terms, these two devices are connected by a network. That network can be a local area network, or the network can be an internet too. So in this part of this course, basically you need to understand how the communication is being carried from one device to another device, that is from one location to another location, or how the data is getting exchanged between this client to the server and the server to the client, and how the information is to be presented on the client side, and how the information has to be retrieved, or how the information has to be processed, or how the information has to be provided, or how the data access should be provided to your requested entity. So there are some tasks which are need to be performed on the server side. There are some tasks to be performed on the client side. And there are certain tasks to be performed between these two entities, that's the client and the server. So if you look to our course, the syllabus of our course, the syllabus for a course, Internet Technologies, basically, this is the same syllabus for integrated MTech students as well as for the MCS students. This syllabus is available on the Moodle, our course web page. So you can try to view that particular syllabus. So to give in a nutshell, of course, this is in continuation to what Dr. Satish Sriram has given to you in the introduction video, which is available on the Moodle. I'm just continuing to that particular part. So the first unit is basically something about the application layer protocols. Some topics related to these protocols. That protocols which are to be used between this client and the server. That is the end-to-end process, which is going to happen some exchange of information. So when you try to have understanding about the exchange of information, that information can be related to emails or simply a file to be transferred from client to server or from server to client, or some data that is to be downloaded from the server and it is to be given to the client. So the first unit covers about what are all the rules to be followed in the exchange of data for different types of data that needs to be traversed between your client and your server. So those protocols are the ones which you are going to understand here, something called as hypertext transfer protocol, simple mail transfer protocol, post office protocol, secure shells, file transfer protocols, P2P protocols such as BitTorrent and distributed hash tables. So this is the one simple architecture, one simple diagram which you are trying to understand here. That is from your side, which you call it as a client. On the client device, you have some application called a browser. From the browser, you are requesting some information which is related to your courses, which is available on a server called SCIS Learn One, which is available on this server, which is available remotely, of course. This is the address for this particular server. So the first unit is all about understanding what are the protocols you need to understand to get some knowledge about the web technologies which are related to getting some information from the client to your server and from server to your client. That's the end-to-end process. If you continue in this direction, then you come across the next unit, that is your client-side technologies. So the client-side technologies is all about this particular side, the left-hand side. So on this left-hand side, which you call it as a client, this client side requires how you can present your data. So this data which is available at the user, there are certain technologies. Technologies, simple terms, there are some techniques. There are techniques means some methods by which you are trying to provide that particular following certain syntax, following certain principles, following certain methods. You try to present your data so that the data can go and fetch the data from the remote computer, that's a server. And whenever the server sends some data back to the requested site, the data has to be presented in a proper way so that the client side or the users can easily understand what the data that has been received from this particular server. So you need to understand certain programming tools which will help you to present the data that needs to be get exchanged between the client and the server. So when you're presenting the data, you may be using certain devices like your laptop or your smartphone, in simple terms, your mobile phone, or an electronic pager or an electronic device. We call it as an electronic gadget. So each device has its own set of specifications, the parameters, some constraints, some limitations, and so on and so forth. So here from the client side, whenever you are trying to request that information which is available on the remote site, so you need to present the data depending on the devices which you use or depending on the methods that you imply to request that particular information, so on and so forth. So the client side technologies, what are those techniques? What are those methods that you need to understand here? So the client side technologies like HTML, hypertext markup language, cascading style sheets, hypertext preprocessor, JavaScript, extended markup language, document object modeling. Of course, these are all related to those technologies which you need to get practiced and get some confidence in writing your own programs, which can be useful for your developing the web applications. So those technologies which are related to this left-hand side, we call it as a client-side technologies. Similarly, there are certain other technologies which needs to be incorporated or which needs to be carried upon on this particular right-hand side. That is, you call it as a server-side technologies. So the server-side technologies basically involves certain kind of processing to be done based on the requests that are coming from the client. So you have something called Java server pages, your database. So basically, you have a database at the server side. So you can have a database here which can store as well as which can provide some data for the requested sites, so on and so forth. So here, you, as a web developer, you need to understand what are all the technologies that are available to effectively develop certain applications which are related to the server side processing, server side management of the data. So those technologies also you will try to understand here what are the available technologies at the server side. So these two units, the unit one is all about the protocols related to the end-to-end process of data exchange. Then unit two discusses about the client side technologies, unit three about the server side technologies, and unit four specifically it emphasizes on the advanced client side technologies. So there are certain technologies, the methods which are available at the client side very much effectively so that you can avoid the latency, you can avoid the delays, you can avoid the internet connections, you can avoid the bandwidths. So you need not always request the data that comes from your server. Something can be much made easier to some extent, depending on the network performance and so on and so forth. So there are certain technologies which can be deployed, which can be incorporated here so that the users get the benefit of using those data very effectively rather than going the request to the server and waiting for those responses to arrive at the later stage. So there are advanced client-side technologies. Similarly, the advanced server-side technologies too are available. That we try to discuss it in the unit number four. So unit number five, obviously, it gives us the latest web applications that are need to be aware of. I think everybody knows the Google. Google is advanced in so many aspects which related to the web applications. So we'll see how the Google search engine is working. What is the functionality of the Google search engine? How that algorithm has been getting evolved, or it is from the beginning how things have changed. We like to understand what are those algorithms which are in practice. Then the Google Maps, of course, the markup languages which needs to be used along the Google Maps is the keyhole markup language. We call it as HTML, which is an extension to our XML. So these are the topics that we try to go about here. So this is the basic scenario why you need to study this particular course. The main purpose of this particular course is to understand the various technologies that are available so that you can develop a very good web application which can be used for our daily purpose using the electronic gadgets more effectively. So that is the reason you need to be very much aware of this, because in this era, the era is basically your information technology era. So everyone should be aware of how these internet technologies will help us to extract or get the information which is spread across the internet, which is spread across the world. So very easily and effectively and very fastly and very robustly. So this course, Internet Technologies, gives you the insights about developing web applications using the latest technologies effectively. And how do we go about this particular course? Basically, this is one structure which is then prescribed for us. The structure contains these are the items. And since now we started with a new learning scenario, basically, please do remember this particular platform that what you are seeing now is a student-centric platform. When I say student-centric platform, in the sense that earlier teacher used to give some materials, teacher used to give lectures in the classrooms, and accordingly teacher gives you some assignments, and of course some tests have been connected to see how far you have been able to understand the topics which have been discussed in the class and other so on and so forth. But now, because of this COVID-19 situation, we have come up to a new learning paradigm where this focus will be on towards students learning rather than from the teacher's perspective. The student has to be very much proactively involved in knowing the things very fastly, of course. And whenever you have some doubts, you need to interact with your teacher and get your doubts to be solved as quickly as possible. And you need to be very much regular. So here, please do remember, as such, there is no class sessions which are happening. So here, what we expect is, by this time, I could see that many of you have seen this Moodle. So, and of course, the 24th to 29th August week is basically related to your sample activities. So I could see from the logs that people, the students are able to view these contents and they're able to submit some assignments. Some 18 to 20 students have submitted various activities. Now, please do remember, this particular sample activities is only to get familiar with the Moodle environment, how it looks like. And in the course of our study, you'll be having several other activities. Depending on the syllabus, we prepare some quizzes, we'll have some assignments, and so on and so forth. So formally, we start those activities from Monday onwards. So you can see from Monday onwards, you'll have topic-wise in each week, what are the topics that are getting discussed. So you will have the slides, you'll have the materials which have been referenced by us. And as well as you need to do some activities, you need to participate in your quizzes, submit your assignments, so on and so forth. And it will be a regular activity. So we don't expect you to do immediately all those things. It is always welcome and is always preferable at your own pace, at your own convenience, at your own time which is available for you. But please do remember, it should not be an indefinite idle time. So you need to be engaged with this course most of the time. You should not be out of the track. So if you have some internet problem or if your devices problem, please let us know. Please send your emails in the form of emails or in the form of messages. See, I can see some of the messages like this on my screen. People do chat with me. So here, we do have certain features on this. So we try to see all you. So we do prefer to have certain kinds of communication. If you are having difficulty in this messaging or Gmail, you can as well have the WhatsApp groups. So we are flexible to that. You can even communicate with us. And please do keep checking on these announcements. So at least weekly once, we do update these announcements. We keep posting some announcements on this particular web pages. So regarding to the practicals, I would like to just say some few words on these practicals, because this particular session is being a combined session for integrated MTech and MCS. For integrated MTech students, yes, the theory contents will be the same, unit 1 to unit 5, and the practicals will be related to these particular units. So let me quickly tell you about something about the practicals, what we have planned for you for this semester through online. I will get back to you about the resources available with you to execute those programs. Just kindly hold on for a few minutes. Let me just say something about what are the practicals. So unit one, once we discuss the topics related to SMTP, HTTP, SSH, and FTP, so you will have a practical exposure to how do you make use of this FTP, SSH, SMTP through the Google SMTP mail servers. So you'll have a little practical exposure to how do we make use of how these protocols are helping us to retrieve the information, to access the information, how the information is getting exchanged. Similarly, you have something called peer-to-peer. Of course, you have seen in this particular PowerPoint, there is a client and there is a server. If there is a particular device which is acting like both the client and the server, that particular system, we call it as a peer system, which is functioning like both, like as a client and as a server. So there are certain devices which are getting connected with each other, which can function both like client and the server. Those systems we call it as peer systems. So we'll understand how the peer-to-peer communication is happening. So in the first unit practicals, you'll understand how to use these protocols. Coming to the second unit, the actual practical starts from this second unit onwards. We'll be writing some programs related to HTML. Exercises will be given and how the cascading style sheets can be embedded along with your HTML and the hypertext preprocessor, PHP, we can use it along with a LAMP stack. Of course, people do not get confused with the names, what I'm using here. Slowly, you'll come to know during the lectures and during the video sessions. And during this video sessions, I will try to demonstrate from my laptop itself. So you can have the exposure to these practicals. So all this basically, strictly speaking, from unit 2 to unit 5, entirely the practical parts is there. There is no deviation from any single topic. All single topics have practicals. So we will be definitely touching to maximum extent. So last year I had an experience of completing these practicals at least to 95% of these practicals in the regular lab sessions for the last year seniors, your seniors batch. So I hope at least because now you have an online platform, there is a wider scope to implement all of them also. Of course, there are some limitations in the last year for the other sources. So I think it will not be there in this case. So we start practicals from the next to next week onwards. Once you come to understanding about these protocols, we give some exercises we need to do. Of course, that goes on. Please do remember, on the Moodle web course web pages, you will have certain video lessons. So these video lessons will be given by myself as well as Dr. Satish Sri Rama. Sometimes the topics may be same, sometimes the topics may be different. But we do provide the video lessons here, which what we have planned to cover is around 15 to 20 minutes of video sessions, followed by whatever the slides that have been used in that video sessions will be made available to you, and some references from those slides, which you need to get further information from those references will also be made available to you. And there will be a quiz related to that particular topic. That questions which are related to that quiz contains multiple choice questions, true or false, fill in the blanks. Also, you can have certain video quizzes. There will be a video will be played. During that video, there will be certain questions will be interactively asked from you. So you will have some certain kind of new excitement, new anxiety, how these things will go on. So during the course of our study, you'll get to have all these understandings. So slowly, the next week will start with very slowly. The little small topics will start. So later, after 1 or 2 weeks, then little bit will speed up the process so that you will get into the tune very much easily. So coming to the practicals, so as I mentioned here, for MCS students as well as integrated MTech, officially integrated MTech students have a lab component along with the theory component. But as far as the MCS students is concerned, you have only theory component. There are no credits for the lab. So what I suggest, what I have done in the last year is the MCS students do participate in the assignments, they do participated in submitting the assignments which are related to the practical aspects of these topics. So they have done their practice on their own laptops. Sometimes they used to come to the lab, our AI lab, and they have done certain practice. I accept that not all of them have come, not all of them have done all the exercises as far as the MCA students is concerned. Initially, they were very much interested. Slowly, because of the workload and so many other constraints, they were not able to do those unit 5, to be very frank, as the MCA students are concerned. But around 70 to 80% of the MCAs students, they have done their practicals on their own laptops. That was the last year's scenario. And coming to integrated MTech students, what happened is they had resources like the computers are given in the computer center. That is what in our CNF building. But they have preferred to have their own laptops. The integrated MTech students, your seniors, they prefer to have their own laptops. So they used to install all the softwares, whatever the softwares you require. See, please remember there are several softwares are there. Almost all softwares are open source softwares, which are freely available on the internet. And what the previous students they have done is they have installed their softwares, and what are the exercises I have given, they were used to install those exercises on their laptops, and they used to submit their exercises week wise and accordingly the assignments too. So I am not sure now in this batch how many of you are having your own laptops and how many of you are having internet connectivity. I am not sure. Now at present I have 65 students who are attending this video session out of 82. So if you see here on our Moodle site, all 82 have been registered. So the 82 students here, of course, there are four other teachers. Totally, it shows you 86 here. But there are 82 participants. There are students who have logged in and you are seeing this certain things. You can see the log files and so on and so forth. So we could see who is doing what on the website, who is viewed the activity, but who has not submitted. All these things we can easily monitor here. So please do have an idea about this. So I can say all the students are able to log in as far as this particular course is concerned. And they're able to view the contents here. Maybe one or two students are pending, but their email verification is done, but they are not logged in to see these contents. So if there is anyone who gets that particular information, please do let me know. So here you can see the, as far as this particular course is concerned, who has submitted the sample assignment one. Out of 82 participants, 18 students have submitted. And when I open this, I can see what is the document they have uploaded. I can correct here and I can get back to this. But please do remember, these samples are only for you to get some awareness. So this does not count your evaluation. This sample quizzes, sample assignments. So these things will not be counted. This is only for your practice. So do not worry about the marks on this, but just get an exposure. How do you use this? Because you'll come to know how you can make use of these quizzes, how you can go into these particular things and so on and so forth. So coming to the practicals, so we would like to hear from you how many of you are able to have your own laptops to be used for practice. If you are having Windows, no problem. If you are having Ubuntu, it is preferable, the Linux platform. But Windows also can be acceptable. We will tell you what topic, what software needs to be installed on your laptop to do certain exercises. When we give the exercises, we will inform to you well in advance, at least 1 week before, so that you will keep ready your laptops with the necessary software. As a web developer or as an, of course, as a professional too, you should also get exposure to install your own software. So that will give you a good practice. And whenever you install a software, let me just give you one important point. Whenever you install a software, please do install the stable version of the software. When I say stable, means that software which is not in the testing stage. because in the testing stage there will be certain bugs and those softwares may not work properly. So do not worry about that software. The versions of the software also given to you will be given to you when you are trying to solve the problems. So we would like to hear from you about the availability of the laptops and the internet bandwidths. So once we get some statistics about how many people are able to use their own laptops and they will be able to solve certain exercises, forget about the softwares. You don't worry about the softwares of availability of softwares on your laptop. So we only asking you the information about the availability of laptop and the internet connection. These two things are required. So you will see a time, once we get that information by tomorrow, please do make sure you can send it by emails. So the emails, please do send it to either to me or to sir, anyone is acceptable, whichever is convenient to you. But please do send it to your my email address nks@uhod.ac.in. The mails which you are getting from the Moodle server is basically your scas@moodle.gmail.com. This is exclusively meant for our Moodle server. So please do not reply to this email ID, scas@moodle.gmail.com. Please do not reply. If you have any queries to the Moodle server, you can send your request to this email ID. But whenever we are talking about the course, please do send your mails, the request mails related to the course to my email ID, nks@uhod.ac.in. Similarly, satish.srirama@ut.ee. So we will try to respond to you as quickly as possible. So we expect that particular responses from you about the availability of your laptop and internet connection. So please remember, even if you don't have internet connection, no problem. It is not to be required continuously on your laptop. Once you install the software, that is enough. Internet connection is not required for you to execute the programs. So 99% of your programs can run without internet once your software is installed on your laptop. Even if suppose majority of the students are not having laptop, then there is another alternative is available. I will disclose that alternative to you once we see the statistics. So that is the information which I like to pass it on to you all at this moment. Now let us have some quick chat here, a quick discussions. I'll request one by one. You can come, you can just unmute your mics and you can just have a small queries discussions if you like to have it here. So whenever we have some video meetings, we do request you to keep your mic and videos in mute condition so that everybody will have some clear understanding and the noises will be suppressed. Anyone, I hope you are listening to my words so far. Dr. Satish Srirama, sir. Hello.
Yeah. I'm here.
Yes, sir. Please, if you want to share some views, please, sir, at your place, please.
No, nothing. Okay, so that's a very good introduction, okay, which you have given. So now all the students have listened to it. We also have other video also posted there, so they can go through it. And now is the time. Like, if you have any questions, like we both are here. Okay, you can ask them now. Or like, if anybody is shy, you can also write as mails. Okay, feel free. Happy learning, happy Moodling. Okay, so this is all tested times, and then like new forms of learning. Okay, you are learning, we are also learning the complete procedure. So feel free. So basically, no question is a bad one. Okay, so a good question, we all are learning.
Yeah, yes, sir. Now you are able to, we are able to see you, sir. Yeah.
Yeah. Looking forward to interesting discussions in the lectures, videos, and through mails.
Hey, we request you, please do not keep your doubts like that. Feel free. See, you can communicate with us. If you have individual doubts as well as group doubts, please do not hesitate to ask us. Of course, this is a journey. We are all together in this journey. And we hope this journey will be very fruitful for us. You will gain a lot of knowledge and the skills in developing those web applications. And it will be an interesting for us, every one of us, to have this particular like type of learning. Yeah, now I stop the recording at this moment. If you have doubts, please proceed.